Okay, I'm ready to glue up my door now. So this mahogany that you saw me working on, I went ahead and put two more coats on, give six coats. And so I'm ready to pinch this panel together in the tongue and groove, get it aligned, and trap it inside this door frame here, you know, my mortise and tenon door frame. And as you remember, when I finished the panel pieces, I also finished the edges at the same time, this inside edge of the four door components. So you can see that the mahogany is going to fit in, the panel fits in like this. And so it's very difficult to finish into these corners really cleanly and get that beautiful stroke on the, you know, just that absolute perfect finish like you can with it when you have a free movement across the end of the board. That's why I pre-finished these, and now I'm just going to trap them inside this. Before I pinch it all together, I ran mineral oil, just regular mineral oil that you can get at the grocery store. I ran a rag inside of all of these tongue and grooves, just so when I trap this together that I don't have any resistance. So there's a little bit of lubrication that's going to allow the panel to seat into final position. You know, I'm not gluing the panel. I'm allowing it to free float. I'm only gluing my mortise and tenon joints. So the panel on the inside is going to be bounded by these shoulders, but I don't want there to be resistance, finish resistance, when I press everything together. So I use a little bit of mineral oil. Mineral oil is completely compatible with this oil-based Waterlox finish. So if a little bit gets on, I can just wipe it off and it just doesn't seem to affect it at all. Now I love this Type-On 3 and I like Type-On 2 a lot, but the problem with these for me gluing up doors is that they set up so fast that a lot of times I don't have the open time that I want to really get my adjustments and squareness and everything just the way I like it. Plus, these work by evaporation. So when water evaporates out of this, that means that the volume shrinks. And so that means that something is shrinking inside my mortise and tenon joint. And I make these joints to where they, you know, they actually slip and are easy to get together. I don't want to drive them together, because if you make them so tight, you can actually bust the sides out using a piston hydraulic action. So they have to be loose enough to fit. So I want something that's going to take up every bit of that loose space and be able to squeeze out comfortably and give me the open time that I want to glue this up. And what I've used for years, for 20 years, is this PC7. And it's a two-part epoxy. I have about an hour that I can get all my clamps, I can take things and reposition them and get them just the way I like them. And whenever I glue a door up like this, so this is on my work table, I have it hanging off both ends so I can have access with the clamps, but I always glue this up with clamping calls. And by clamping calls, I mean you'll see that I'm going to have I join these pieces of scrap wood so they're absolutely flat and straight. So there's going to be one on the top and on the bottom. Here's a drop of mahogany that are going to be pinched by a big C clamp before my pipe clamps go on. So it's going to pull this into absolutely flat plane to make sure that there is not any distortion or rack when the clamps go on. So that it's just a real good way to do it. And you don't want to, since there's going to be epoxy squeezing out of this, you can't just let it be wood to wood, or this will bind to your door, and when you try to break it free, you may tear a hunk off of it. So what you just do, what you use is just a simple piece of paper. I just save old magazines or catalogs, and so there'll just be a piece of paper in here. So that will stop the epoxy from being wood to wood. It'll just go to the paper, and then I'll just peel that piece of paper off. And a lot of times the epoxy, you'll see it'll actually transfer the image into the wood, but it just so superficially, you just sand it away.